summer in Maine. Nothing like a nice dip in the ocean on a warm, sunny day and freezing cold water. Yeah, the ocean water off the coast of Maine is cold. But the Gulf of Maine is actually warming faster than most of the world's oceans. Why is it warming so fast? And how does that impact Mainers? That's what we're diving into today. This is Maine Explained. I'm Esta Pratt-Kielley, and I went to the Gulf of Maine Research Institute to get some answers. As you can guess by their name, they study all things Gulf of Maine. And they're tracking the surface temperature of the Gulf over time using satellite images. Over the past 40 years, the Gulf warmed significantly, 3 times the global average. And 2021 was the warmest year on record. Let's be clear, all of the world's oceans are warming. People are adding more greenhouse gases to the atmosphere, which traps excess heat on the Earth's surface. And most of that heat is actually stored in the ocean. But oceans aren't warming the same amount everywhere.
It's safe to say that in any given year, the Gulf of Maine is warming faster than at least 95% of the ocean surface.
Scientists like Dave Reidmiller think there are a few reasons why. The first has to do with 2 ocean currents, which are both changing. The Labrador Current brings cold water down from the Arctic, while the Gulf Stream brings warm water up from the tropics. For the Gulf Stream, imagine a garden hose.
Right, it used to be a pretty concentrated stream, like a jet spray setting. And over time, it's almost like you've shifted the dial into more of a shower spray. So instead of this powerful jet, it's sort of widened a little bit.
That spray setting spreads the warm water around to more parts of the Gulf of Maine. Now, for the Labrador Current, imagine a faucet with cold and hot water taps.
We know that the Arctic is warming really fast, and so the Labrador Current, the ocean water up there, is also warming. So that, you know, cold faucet that was the Labrador Current is now becoming a slightly less cold faucet.
So cold water tap gets turned down, warm water tap gets turned up. And finally, the shape of the Gulf contributes to why it's warming so fast. There's a small channel just off Nova Scotia, the Northeast Channel, which is where scientists believe most of that warm water from the Gulf Stream enters the Gulf of Maine. And George's Bank off Cape Cod forms sort of an underwater plateau, so warm water coming in stays in the Gulf because it's mostly closed off from the Atlantic Ocean.
In a sense, it kind of creates almost a bit of a bathtub within the Gulf of Maine.
So why does this all matter?
With the exception of 2019, every one of the last 10 years have been in the top 10 warmest years on record in the Gulf of Maine. So we really have seen quite a significant shift in terms of the level of warming in the Gulf of Maine recently.
Over the past decade, Reidmiller says there's been about a quarter of a degree Fahrenheit of warming, which might not seem like a lot, but over time has a real impact. Just think about when you have a fever.
Our body is accustomed to a particular temperature, right? When we run a fever of a couple of degrees, we start to feel kind of icky and slowed down, can't really think straight, whatever. When we start running a fever of 4, 5, 6 degrees or so, systems start to shut down, right? And that same thing can happen in the Earth system and in the Gulf of Maine ecosystem.
And while that ocean water might still feel cold, there are noticeable changes. Warming water makes the Gulf less hospitable to the species who call it home, while new or invasive species thrive and disrupt the food web, and commercial fisheries that are a big part of the New England economy. And back to physics 101, when water heats up, it expands, causing the sea level to rise, which leads to flooding that can wreak havoc on homes and infrastructure. These impacts are forcing us to take action, from adopting new fisheries and preparing our shorelines for rising seas, to collaborating on reducing emissions. And Reidmiller says we have a responsibility to share what we learn.
I talk all the time about how we have a living laboratory in our own backyard here. And so while the Gulf of Maine is warming faster than most of the places in the planet, it also provides us with an opportunity to learn, to understand what's happening here, and to really transfer some of those lessons to other places around the world so they're not caught off guard when they experience the levels of warming that we're seeing.
So, coastal communities will have to keep adapting to a warming Gulf of Maine. And the solutions that we come up with here could have global impacts. For now, that's the warming Gulf of Maine explained. Like this video if you learned something new about Maine, And subscribe to our YouTube channel for even more from Maine Public. As Maine's official public media organization, we're proud to bring free radio, television, and digital news and entertainment to Mainers every day. Support our work at mainepublic.org/donate.